We're going to take out a 10-ton unit.
Maybe to save on the motor? I don't know. Yeah. I can think of anything else.
Yeah, yeah, for sure, the motor. We're going to take out the 10-ton water-cooled unit. We're going to put an air-cooled split unit downstairs. We got two compressors, two water-cooled condenser tubs, and a blower. This is covered. I'll let you guys see how it looks after you get everything out. We're stripping it down because we have to finish in that walkway. We're going to strip down the whole unit. This is the room all cleaned up. Day two, got the new air handler up here, got the secondary drain pan in, got the piping for the dual circuits piped in, coming out of the circuits going into the main suction line, 3/8 and an 1 1/8. Gotta come back tomorrow. Right now it's 10:30 at night, so we gotta put a float switch, gotta do the electrical. Put a breaker in, run a circuit, and so far this is what we got. This is a 10-ton Daikin split system. I'll show you down by the condenser. That's why we gotta take it apart, because the unit, you gotta fit it under that beam. There's a steel beam there. Here. Still we're leaving for the night. Let's see. So I gotta get that unit up the stairs and into the bedroom, into that room there. You can see up there. I'm gonna show you the condenser so far. So they got the piping. That's where the air handler sits. Come down the wall. Get that little cover. Got it there like that. And it comes over into the condenser. We got a sight glass. We got it pressurized with nitrogen right now. And we're gonna see if it holds in the morning. Well, we'll come back tomorrow afternoon. Lately on this job, we've been working at night. So, it's not too hot. We gotta put a disconnect. Got a filter dryer inside there. Product, air handler, ductwork inside their drain pan. Got the filters, it's a free return. We put the filter size here. Got the main drain, goes down, the secondary drain tees into it. We leave the ball valve off. You leave it off, so obviously it doesn't suck all air through there. Got a float switch in the pan. The belt size at 841. Got the piping. We ran the high voltage circuits, had to put three phase breakers in. Got that compressor.
compressor blade go ahead and have it
comes up. So I'll show you outside. It's more detailed. Show you downstairs.
I think I like it.
Finished. No, that's okay. No, no problem. So Cassandra, what are you going to do? You want to take lunch? That's the line cover. Goes down. Got the unit strapped down. This is our thermostat wire coming in from upstairs. This is our disconnect. Say glass on. I mean, I really don't know much what to say, but it's pretty basic unit. You know, straightforward. Got a 1-inch drain on it. Yeah, I didn't want to talk too much upstairs, but the reason why we put a ball valve, so that way if you if the drain line backs up and it overflows the secondary, you don't have to vacuum all that water. You just open the ball valve and let it drain out. But you want to keep it closed, obviously. You only open it when you need it to drain. But this is a 10-ton split unit, pretty straightforward. I haven't did a video in a while, so we ran the EMT conduit, disconnected it, we did all that. So, all right.